They provide the soundtrack to spring. Whether you are an avid bird watcher or just take them in stride, the chorus of chirps and cheeps are a sign that spring has arrived.
It's morning chorus, and they're most active right at dawn. You get out there right at dawn, and it's special.
Stephen Myrick has been a birder for more than 40 years. He knows the calls so well, he can identify a species on the spot. In fact, the birds interrupted our interview with Stephen more than once.
Oh my gosh, I think I hear a Wilson's warbler over here. Oh, black-throated green. Oh, there goes a pileated woodpecker flying by. And that's the way it is. And you don't even have to move. You just can sit one spot. And I got a fish crow.
So what is all that singing about?
Over the next 4 weeks, as these birds are all arriving back, the first thing they're doing is singing. Singing is the way these birds establish territories. Even though some of them are actually migrating through, it's in their juices. All they're doing is they're establishing their boundaries. So, you know, I've heard a couple of different cardinals singing right here. And basically they're saying, all right, this is my territory. And they know what it is. We don't, but they know where it is. They won't cross over.
We caught up with Stephen and other folks from the Audubon Society at the sanctuary in Auburn near Lake Massabesic. But it's not just singing we heard. Pileated woodpeckers, known for their bright strip of red, very busy on this day. The constant drumming of this guy could be heard as he busily pecked away at this tree.
The drumming of the woodpecker says, this is my territory. Stay out.
The New Hampshire Audubon Society has been protecting birds and other wildlife for over 100 years. Established in 1914, the Audubon Society has nearly 40 wildlife sanctuaries around the state and is one of the oldest Audubon societies in the country.
The Audubon history is focused on protecting birds and bird habitat. We've been an organization for over 100 years. So we focus on environmental education, bird science, protecting lands, and influencing environmental policy.
Audubon President David Bechtel says birds can actually tell us about the health of the environment, especially when certain species begin to disappear.
Well, one easy example is that many of our birds of prey, specifically bald eagles and peregrine falcons, were disappearing from the United States because of poison called DDT. And as soon as DDT was banned from the environment, those two species and many others rebounded.
But it's not just environmental hazards that can kill off the bird population. There is another predator deemed dangerous to birds, and it's one many of us adore. Yes, cats, we're talking to you. Keep your cat indoors, folks, and let it view birds from inside the house. Another hazard? Large windows.
Putting things on their windows, like the stickers that you see that are the shape of a falcon or a bird of prey, will keep birds from running into windows. And windows also kill millions and millions of birds every year.
Every day is like a new one.
Bob Quinn has been birding for more than 45 years. As a nature guide, he takes clients all over the world to see our fine feathered friends. He knows his birds.
Tree swallows calling, chipping sparrow, bluebird, red-bellied woodpecker out in the woods there. A good birder can locate and identify 80 to 90% of the birds by voice. I spent most of my time in Central and South America, but Australia, Africa, Bhutan, the most exotic place I've ever been.
Wow.
But a lot of our birds go to Central America, for instance, for the winter. They're coming back now, and they're partway here. We get a thrill of excitement in May when all these warblers and other brightly colored birds come back.
But not all species are returning in large numbers. Dr. Pamela Hunt is a senior biologist with the Audubon Society and author of a recent report called State of Birds in New Hampshire. Tracking bird populations, she says about one half of species here is declining.
They could be local threats like habitat loss and development, which obviously is still going on. For most of these species, are migratory, and they leave New Hampshire in the fall and get back here this time of year. And for those 8 to 9 months of the year, they're nowhere even near here, and they have to face the same threats. So if there's habitat loss or an oil spill or deforestation or any of these things happening in Latin America or the Caribbean or even Florida, that can carry up to the populations we see here.
Since the pandemic, folks of all ages took advantage of the Audubon trails.
We've made sure our trails are open during the pandemic, and we've really encouraged people to enjoy birds as a way to connect to nature during this tough time.
What's especially fun about birding in the spring is that you're likely to see birds at their most colorful. That's because it's mating season, so the male birds especially will boast these bright, brilliant colors in an effort to attract his female partner.
The Audubon has dozens of these boxes encouraging species like bluebirds and swallows to breed, nest, and raise their young here. They also need to fatten up. Migrating birds can travel up to 600 miles a day. Some species sleep while flying.
They need places to rest and to feed, and they'll look for areas, particularly along the edges of ponds in poor weather, where they can still find insects, because these are insect-eating birds that are coming through now, that are returning. So you can see lots of birds, they're beautiful, they're singing, and after a long winter, it's just so nice to see them back again.